What's going on, folks? It's E-Dub, one of the group members of Khemasis. Back at you with another video. In this video, to keep it short and sweet, I'm going to be attempting to build a set of studio monitor stands. Overall height's going to be 29 inches off the ground, and that's going based off the height of my table and the height that I'm usually sitting on my chair when I'm mixing or even producing. So it's going to be a bunch of small clips of video showing the progress, and I'm hoping it comes out good. If not, I just lost like $13 in material. So it's not expensive, and if anybody's looked into studio stands or studio monitor speaker stands, they're way overly priced for something that you can do yourself if you're handy. So I'll be back with the next video showing the steps I've taken. All right, here's just a mock-up. It's actually not glued or screwed into play. I just actually just put it together, so that way you guys get an idea of the layout that I'm looking to do. Not too shabby. There was another way I could have done it, but I'm kind of feeling this method more. So I'm going to go ahead and put it together. I may actually take some videos of each step. Don't know, but I'll be back. Alright, here's a mock-up of the actual beam that'll be supporting the weight of the monitors. As you can see here, I measured out in between and lined it up on both sides. I so happen to have some wood glue in my room. So I have, I'm gluing it into play now. I will be screwing it in, but just gluing it in to where it stays in place. So that way when I do screw it in, I don't have to worry too much about it moving and misalignment. And I will be drilling a pilot hole in first, so that way I'm not putting too much force into when I actually drive the screw in, and it'll stay in place for me, hopefully. So I'll be back with the next step. I'm gonna do the other one using these two pieces. All right, here's the next update. Got one of the beams on the base part of the board, or maybe what even turn into the top. If you pay attention, what I did was I measured it out as far as to the distance from here to here, which is a total of 7 inches, and from here to here, which is 5.5. Now, with that being said, this base, this board right here is 12 inches long, 12 inches wide. So just subtracted, divided by 2, and got the outside measurement to where I can actually form a square, which you can probably see with the outline. Knowing that within that square, this beam has to line up in the back exactly. And this would actually line up to the front, which it did. So again, it's being held in by glue. I haven't put any screws in yet. And that'll probably be my last step, is putting the screws in. But right now, it's being held in by glue. So I'm going to actually let that dry a little bit. And do the same measurement with the next board, and then flip it over. And after that, I'll be putting probably a total of 2 screws on each side, one here and one here, and probably one in the back right here, just to keep it this piece screwed in with this. So I don't want it to be held, these two pieces of wood to be held in just by glue alone. So I'll be getting back to you with the next step in the progress. Alright guys, I'm done. Here's a finished product. Still has to be painted, which I'll be using some Krylon black satin paint. Nothing too glossy, nothing too flat. Being held in 2 screws, top and bottom. The method I used was actually drilling it twice. The first one was a smaller hole, which the screw actually went in and followed in. And the first time when I did that, the screws actually sat on top, and it was actually making this uneven to where it would wobble on the floor, or the monitor would wobble on top of it. So I drilled the bigger hole on top, so that way when I screwed the screw in, it would be recessed inside of there, and I'll have a flat surface, top and bottom. So I'll be coming back with the finished product actually spray painted, and that'll be it. Alright folks, here it is, the end product. I'm very much satisfied with it. I totally recommend that if anybody needs studio monitor stands, it's best that you build it yourself. Because this thing is sturdy, it looks nice, and it cost me what I, being that fact that I had already wood screws in my room, this literally cost me what, $13 to do, compared to spending about over $100 for a pair of stands that you can make, which I made for $13. So, that's about it. I'm gonna close it there. I will say before I leave, please subscribe, comment, rate, you know, let us know what you think about the music that we put in out, whether you like it or not. Any form of comment is taken constructive. So stay tuned. This is...